Hi, everybody. Well, I was putting together the new Case-Shiller charts. I updated the data this morning and I was putting them online. I noticed a new article came in from the National Association of Realtors, and it quoted the head economist, the chief economist from the National Association of Realtors, and he said that the home price is increasing, the rate that they were increasing was unhealthy and unsustainable. The pace of home price increases was unhealthy and unsustainable. That is totally wild, because the National Association of Realtors was famous back during the boom and bust for the chief economist they had back then. For he would belittle people. He would said that there was a real estate boom. When prices were clearly starting to fall, he was saying, oh, they're still great, they're going to go up. He was a cheerleader for home prices and for the industry. And he kind of became a national joke, really. And it was that whole idea, it's like, always a good time to buy. And that was embodied by this guy, David Lara. This is a big change in policy for the National Association of Realtors, for their economists to say that these prices are unhealthy and unsustainable. Means a lot. Now, you're going to see in the rest of this video what he's talking about. He's not talking about the entire country. There's some places where prices are really going up steeply, and other places they're just going up what I call warm, which I'm not too worried about. I'm a little concerned about, but the markets where it's going up very fast, some of those I'm not worried about at all, like Denver and Dallas, or very little, but those I'm extremely worried about, like California, what I call the tech markets. There could be a tech bubble going on. And that bubble is bringing up home prices. And if that bubble, that tech bubble burst, it wouldn't lead to a real estate bubble burst in those cities right away, but it would probably stop prices from increasing anymore. So that's what I thought was fascinating. So before I even go into the rest of the video, look at that. It is amazing that the National Association of Realtors would say that. They're basically saying prices are too high. I think that's what they're saying.
All right, so let's look at the 9 hottest markets according to the Case-Shiller numbers. Now, this is the Case-Shiller. It's all graphed out on my website, Real Estate Decoded. And the way they do it, it makes it really easy to compare different cities, is they put whatever the price was in January of the year 2000 as 100. And then you can look at the changes in prices since that time. And you can see there's some really big bubble cities in here, a couple of cities that were kind of bubbly, but not as bad as the others. And then 2 cities really didn't have much of a bubble at all, Denver and Dallas. And you see Denver and Dallas are phenomenally less appreciated since January of 2000 than the rest of the markets. And let's see, let's look at this pink one. Holy mackerel, that's San Francisco. San Francisco, I think, is in a tech bubble. There's a lot of talk in the tech industry that there is a tech bubble. And that would reflect in the home prices. That would also reflect in Seattle. In Portland, and these are Seattle and Portland, that are right, almost right on top of each other. They're increasing very rapidly as well. Denver, it turns out, has a little bit of a tech play in recent years. I didn't realize that, but when I saw that it was increasing so rapidly, I kind of figured there was something else going on. Denver does have an oil shtick to it, to the economy, but also a tech. So that could be what's going on, or it could be, you can see that it's still underpriced compared to these others when you compare it to the price in January 2000. Okay, enough of that. So that gives you a feel of what's going on. I'm concerned that there's a tech bubble and that that's going to hurt prices. If it does bust, some people in the tech industry say the tech bust, not necessarily the real estate, the tech bust could happen as soon as the end of this year. So that gives you an idea. Once that happens, home prices wouldn't fall immediately, but they would stop going up. And typically, by the way, in bubble real estate bubble science, usually prices have to be flat for a couple of years before they start to fall. So I don't expect prices to fall anytime soon, but that they could stop going up for sure. Okay, so let's look at the 11 homes that are warm but not hot. And you see a lot of these 4 cities in here didn't really have a boom, from Detroit to Cleveland to Atlanta and Charlotte. Not really much of a real estate boom, although Detroit did have a bust but didn't have a boom. So you can see that that's going on. There's some of these had a little bit of a boom and a bust, but not a major one. And we do have some up here like Washington, D.C. Washington, D.C., look at this. During the bust, 2009 to 12, it was higher than any other of these 20 cities that Case-Shiller has compared to their price in 2000. They really didn't fall that much. They were doing great, but I included them in here because, they really don't have much upward momentum, or maybe no upward momentum right now. So they're warm, but they're definitely a lot like the homes we just saw. Look at these here. They're just pretty Boston, New York. Thank geez, that looks pretty flat. Although, hey, to be honest, we're going into the spring, and if we would see, this is only through April, if we would see a big bump, it would be in May, maybe into June. So we should expect that the next month these will go up more than they have now, but they're not coming in with much momentum going upward. There's Phoenix, a little bit of upward momentum. So we got some little, they're warm markets, they're just not hot like the other ones.
So good. I hope that video wasn't too boring for you, but I'm targeting this for geeky people like me. So if you made it this far, you're in the club. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. And of course, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe to realestatedecoded.com and I get a free report in there that tells you the best way to sell a home. A little bit of a long shot, but the best way. And also, if you're watching this on YouTube, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. It's called John at Real Estate Decoded. Great. Thanks, everybody. I really appreciate it.